was a major incident.
At your house?
No.
Oh.
At Mass.
Oh.
At Mass yesterday.
You got Mass.
I didn't go to Mass because I only go back once.
Well, that was your punishment.
Well, I think it was. I think I was struck down. I was having some me time at home, which is code for doing the washing. And so Tom went along with the kids and Paul got himself locked in the confessional booth.
Oh.
He's so naughty. He runs around this church.
I've seen the photos.
Oh, like a little psychopath. And he locked himself in the confessional booth. He was stuck in there for about 10 minutes and they had to call emergency services to break the door down. The fireys and the police were brilliant from all reports. In fact, one of them, they were like, even like making like wisecracks going, it's probably the first time anyone's come out of the closet in this place. having the time of their lives. And they were so good, and they were so good to Paul. But it got us talking, got us thinking about parenting fails, yes. Like just outrageous situations your kids have gotten themselves into and how you got them out. So we put out a call on Facebook. This one is from Belinda. She said, when my daughter played netball and we thought she just rolled her ankle, she kept her carnival only to playing her carnival only to find out a week later that she actually did tendons and ligaments in her foot and had to be in a boot for 8 weeks. I felt like a terrible parent. There's this one as well, excuse me, from Susie. I put my two-year-old backwards in her bath seat, took olive oil and a lot of tears to get her out. Oh, my gosh! That's hilarious. Any parenting fails you'd like to share?
One Sunday morning, I'm cooking breakfast, put the kids in their gumboots and their dressing gowns and put them outside. And you know Jimmy Swaggart?
No.
He's the
preacher.
The preacher. And he's hallelujah. Yeah. And I'm in the kitchen. Hallelujah. The toast is cooking. And it was ages and ages ago. Anyway, the next thing I hear crying, and the two boys have come back up the hill without their gumboots on. They'd walked into the dam and got there. And their gum. I walked down, and the gumboots are in the dam, and they've walked back and all
could
muddy.
They swim?
They're only little.
Oh.
So there could have been an absolute disaster, but I was hallelujah, the toast was cooking.
Wow.
And
I can't
Amelia
think of
is
one.
Such a sensible little girl.
I honestly can't think of one. I mean, I must have stuffed.
You're the Uber mum, though. Like, you are super, super.
Yeah. I have my moments. I'll probably think of one as soon as we get to the break. Go, Joe.
Well, I've told you the story. Speaking of the emergency services coming out, there was one group you missed, which is the Ambos. We had to call the ambulance, had to call the paramedics because I was bathing Henry and, of course, you know, we didn't know what we were doing, first-time parents, and we were so attentive and we'd cover him in olive oil and everything for his skin. And we're on the kitchen bench. It's a tiled floor. The bench is about this high. And he just literally at that moment, I think Tara chucked me a jumpsuit to put on him, fell off the thing. I bent down to pick it up, and in that very
second,
he learned how to roll over. And he rolled over, went over the edge of the bench. I, of course, went to grab him and got him, but of course, he's covered with olive oil, so he's like... So I just managed to sort of hold on to... I think I just managed to get a hold of his leg, but he went smack with his head on the tiles.
I remember the morning after this happened. You were traumatised.
Mortified. Absolutely just mortified. Like, I was howling and screaming. I thought, oh, my God, I've killed my only child. I could not... I was beside myself. Tara called the ambulance. It must have been only a minute or two, but it felt like... Forever. I'm holding him and holding him and holding him. Tara says, it says don't shake him. I said, I can't help him.
Was he crying?
He's all
right.
Yeah,
he was crying. He was crying. And the ambos coming up fantastic. And, you know, they take him in the back of the ambulance. They had to take me too in the back of the ambulance. Because I was and they showed him the stretcher. And just as they're putting the stretcher up in the back of the ambulance and showing the door, they say, oh, just wondering, mate, is that your first child? I said, yeah, it is. How did you know? He goes, by the time it's the third, you just give them a bit of chocolate.
I will say this to young mums who have got kids that fidget when you're trying to put nappies on and everything.
Mm.
Do it on the floor.
Yeah.
Because it happened with Pete.
Yeah.
Twice he went off the bed in a motel. It was carpet on the floor. And then after that, just on the floor. Try and do it on a bench or anything or on the change table. Just put them on the floor and then there's no harm done.
Yeah. Or just don't oil them up. It's fair to say, Bonnie's never been touched by a bowl of olive oil in her life. All right, yeah, whatever.
Dry skin.
So there you go. All's well that ends well.
It's all
though.
Fine, yeah. He's, yes. You know.
Did he go to confession when he was in there?
Yeah, what do you reckon he did?
I don't know.
Like, what was he telling?
He's just, because there's no, like, kind of, I call it kids club, but there's no, like, Sunday school or anything.
Sunday school, yeah.
Yeah, they don't have that. So we sit up the back and he just, it's 45 minutes mass.
This is this kid that thinks he's a dog and licks the furniture.
Yes.
And then also when all the other kids are sitting down over here, all nice, he's over here twirling.
Yes. Yeah.
That's him.
He's full of beans. And, usually... He also said to the priest a few weeks back, "Hello, God." I don't know how. Like, I think he just... And weirdly, apparently it was right at the end and the whole congregation was, like, standing around going... just get the key, just get the key. And Tom's like swishing, going, "Well, if there was a key, I'd be getting the key, wouldn't I?" on the phone to Register Services. But they were so beautiful, the fireys, and they tried to show Paul the truck and everything afterwards and gave him a little plastic hat, which was very, very sweet, but he was a bit traumatised.
It's quite ironic that the only way we'll find out what he was doing in the confession box is if he goes back to the confession box next week.
Indeed.